This is CVR English and it's time to roll the prime time news hour with me Anukriti Sharma. Ladies and gentlemen, India has finally arrived as the chess nation. Our chess masters have created history. They have clinched a double gold at the Chess Olympiad in Budapest. This is a worldwide chess event and India has won in both men's and women's categories. In addition, the team also walked away with 4 individual gold medals. This is an unbelievable feat, viewers, and it wouldn't have been possible without India's golden generation. The young crop that is finally taking over at the top of world chess. Our show tonight tells you more. Take a look at this. Exactly how you celebrate a win as grand as that. Viewers, sports certainly plays an integral role in shaping a child holistically, and to discuss this importance of sports, especially in the formative years of a child, who better to invite live on our show than an academician and a scholar herself, all the way from Lucknow. She is the principal of Junior Delhi School and also the academic director of Junior Delhi School's head office in New Delhi, Miss Samina Warsi. She is a speaker herself, having hosted live shows on Akashvani for more than 5 years. Ma'am, we welcome you to our prime time news hour.
Thank you so much, Anukriti ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, I will get right into the show with you. Briefly take us through your own academic journey, and although you are a scholar yourself, what inspired you to make sports a priority for the holistic development of the students at your school?
Yes, ma'am, during this journey, 21 years of experience, what I have realized, I'm innovating myself every day and rediscovering myself every day. And during this journey, what I have realized in my schools, whenever I have planned a sports day, sports week, it is always so overwhelming, so energizing. It is so rejuvenating. So at times, what happens when we see with academics? So there are, you know, frontliners and backbenchers. Now, today, backbenchers are not there because we are under the process of, you know, seats rotation. But backbenchers mean children who are not very participative in academics, right? But it's so amazing when we see during the sports day, sports week, children who are, you know, so quiet during academics, they suddenly get so confident and so happy and so, you know, active during the session. So it is always so overwhelming seeing them at fields. And last year, as you know, you were also there as a guest.
I remember.
We had a theme of Khelo India Khelo.
Yes. Indeed. So it is just so overwhelming to watch these small kids, these children, bursting and oozing with energy when it comes to the sports field. Ma'am, how important, however, are indoor sports? Indoor sports like chess for the overall holistic development of the children of our nation when it comes to the sharpening of the mind. I believe chess definitely plays a very important role.
Definitely, ma'am. When we talk about sports, whether indoor or outdoor, both kind of sports, ma'am, it conditions the mind of a person to take success as well as failure. Success is always, you know, happiness and overwhelming and welcoming. But actually, every failure brings so many opportunities, because when we face failure, we reevaluate ourselves, rejuvenate, recollect ourselves, and of course, we restructure the plans and policies we make. So definitely, we should teach our children that success is always very good. We should know how to handle the success, but usse bhi zyada it is important that to how to take the failures. That is the actual place where we grow, where we innovate, where we rejuvenate, where we reconstruct ourselves. So any kind of sports, because there's always a one team who's a winner and the other one is the loser. So the loser has a better opportunity to grow.
Absolutely true. Very well spoken. Very interesting point. The loser actually has a higher potential to grow higher and go upward. Ma'am, considering the recent win which India has had, considering the recent double gold which India has won in the sports of chess, Pragnanand from India, who won the second highest honor in sports, the Arjuna Award in 2022, and his sister from the same home, R. Vaishali, was also felicitated with the same honor a year later in 2023 by Honorable President Draupadi Murmu. 5-time Grandmaster Vishwanathan Anand, I'm sure everyone knows his name, has now put a lot of emphasis on more women participation in sports as well. Ma'am, I want to know from you, according to your observation as an educator and also as an edupreneur now, what do you have to say about the current sports culture of our country? Do we see this gender disparity decreasing? Are more and more girls now beginning to participate in sports? Are they being encouraged by their families to participate in sports, keeping in mind the patriarchal structure of our society?
Yes, ma'am, of course, very valid question. And definitely, we are moving in the, modern age, and we can see the change. We can see the change in the society. Definitely, the change is gradual and it has to be more rapid. But it is always, everywhere in India, you can see ladkiyon ko kitna zyada beti bachao, beti padhao, abhiyan tha, abhi usme ek cheez aur, beti khilao. Okay? So, beti bachao, beti padhao, aur kaise beti ko khilao. So, that should be the slogan in every state, or state universities should be, sports universities should be introduced by every state. And I was reading an article, so it was mentioned ki why US and why, China is taking all the credit and they are, doing so well in the sports and everywhere, just because China is identifying the talent at very early stage. So there should be something, should be organized at state level, where the recognition should be at school level, primary level. There the children should be identified, they should be specially trained, special assistance should be given, special coaches. So because what happens in India, we imagine we give only one period, 30 minutes in a week for sports for the whole class, okay, and we are expecting gold every year. So is it possible? No, it is not possible. Definitely few are good at academics, few are good at sports. So for that, it is very important that kids should take the initiative, government should take the initiative to identify these talents at school level. So from there, we can, make plans, policies, we can, train them in a better way, we can give them special opportunity, and then the, government takes the front foot. So school will also, and every school should definitely, we being educators, we are there to develop, to give the holistic development for our children. So that is not only for academics, that should be for sports also. And as you have noticed last year, we have dedicated the whole year to Khelo India Elo. So initially, we started with the presentation, then it was followed by so many other activities, then sports day, then finally last but not least with the annual function. So each and every aspect of sports was taken care of. So This is how, because when the child decides, or a girl, especially the girl, when the girls decide that they want to go in sports first, the parents should take initiative, then the school should take the initiative, and last but not the least, our government should support them, because women are better managers. It's again a different topic of debate, but women are doing, girls are doing everywhere, and you cannot deny, Anukrit ma'am, that, you know, girls are, by God's grace, we are given by special, God has given us special powers. So special powers are now, people can see, now the world can see the change, and women are taking over the seat. So, see, you are there. I am so always so, so inspired by you.
Like you rightly said, ma'am, and there is also this very famous English saying, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy, and now we should extrapolate it and say that it also makes Jill a dull girl. But although, ma'am, you are telling us, you are definitely telling us that a change is taking place in the society constructively, it is a positive change, it is taking place slowly and steadily, with the gender disparity becoming less and less when it comes to participation in sports. But let's hit some hard facts here. You are in Uttar Pradesh as you are talking to us. We are in Hyderabad here. Tell us what is, take us through the structure, the societal structure of Uttar Pradesh in general, keeping in mind the capital of Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow as well. What do you see around you, ma'am, as a principal of your school, as an educator, and as a parent yourself, as a mother yourself? What do you see in the families of Lucknow and Uttar Pradesh in general? Are the girls of the families really, genuinely being encouraged more and more to participate in sports? Or is it still the stereotypical mindset ki ladki ko padhao, ek degree mil jaye, uske baad uski shaadi kara do, uski ek family honi chahiye? Are we still stuck with that stereotypical mindset? Or is Uttar Pradesh really progressing in this matter and taking proactive steps through the families and encouraging their girls more and more to participate? What is the real story of Uttar Pradesh?
Ma'am, as I already told you, time is changing. If we talk about our childhood, whenever a girl, you know, we also had this mindset, because, you know, everybody around us, everybody was like, ki padhna hai, degree paani hai, doctor banna hai, engineer banna hai. Nobody says ki tumko gold lena hai. Girls se to bilkul bhi, nobody was like that.
Aur gold so, agar lena hai to class mein lena hai, kisi subject mein, English mein, maths mein lena hai, sports mein nahi.
Exactly. So I was also very much interested in basketball. So I used to go to the stadium, but I played a few matches. So of course, you know, sports is a tough thing, physically tough. So, you know, my neighbor started saying, please don't send her for practice. She'll become very dark. And then who will marry her? Imagine, now I think. And
exactly, the stereotypical.
I think, oh, what a crazy people.
Huh? In fact, sorry to break you here. The same thing happened with me as well. I was always a keen runner. But some people came to my parents too and said, ki dekhiye, yahan par kitni dhoop hoti hai. लड़की काली हो जाएगी, फिर इससे शादी कौन करेगा? Exactly. So, ma'am, please continue.
So now I can see the change. Now parents, now I am being a parent. I encourage my daughter. I tell her, I don't want anything. I just want you to play. You play, because, you know, playing. Okay, if the child is extraordinary, definitely the child will raise the bar, and definitely he or she will make some place at state level, national level. But what if the child is not that extraordinary? Then too, sport is something very, very important for the holistic development, to for the stress management, for the condition of mind. So it is, as I told you earlier, it teaches the person to take success as well as failure. So that is very important. It is nothing to it is nothing related to, you know, if you are extraordinary, then only the parents should promote sports. Parents should promote sports even if the child is ordinary, because that is very important for the health, happiness, and the mental health of the child.
Ma'am, please take us through the proactive steps which have been taken by your school to further encourage and facilitate more participation in sports by your students. Tell us more about this new collaboration, this venture that your school has entered into with regards to raising more awareness about the importance of sports and physical education in the holistic development of children. I believe that your school has recently entered into a collaboration with a famous sports academy in Uttar Pradesh.
Yes, ma'am, sure. Actually, as I told you earlier, last year we had the whole session dedicated to Khelo India Khelo. During that session, I realized my student Arundhati was there, Ali Khan. They were, you know, very much, you know, very quiet at academics. And Arundhati is a very, very good lawn tennis player. So, but she was not able to cope up with the academics. So, what happened? That during that time, we realized if the child has suddenly, you know, the nature, the child changed, her nature, everything was changed. So that time I realized that this is so, so important, and we have our school ground. So I had a talk with Mr. Prashant. He's a top tennis coach at national level at KD Singh Babu Stadium. So we had a collaboration with him, and then from there we started, and we had a tie-up with him. And tie-up has nothing, it is just to inculcate sports habits to the society. And I have given him free hands to, you know, admit children from outside my school also, because it is not only for, you know, handful children, it is for the whole society.
True.
So we are just taking care that pura society khele. So we are working on that, and definitely you will see the results.
That is definitely a grand vision of yours, ma'am, a very noble vision rather. And the steps that you have taken with KD Singh Babu Stadium, now that's a national academy. That's an academy which has got national, and not just national, international fame. I believe everybody knows about KD Singh Babu Academy, which is located in Lucknow. And the fact that your school is collaborating with an academy of that stature is definitely mind-blowing. It's very awesome to know that your school has collaborated with such a national level academy to promote sports, not just amongst the children of your school, but amongst the entire society of Lucknow. So that's indeed a grand vision. Thank you so much, ma'am, for joining us today at our CVR newsroom, for having this discussion on the importance of sports. We can only hope as people from the newsroom that this awareness will now spread more and more so amongst the parents of India, so that they can start encouraging their children, their girls and boys, to participate more and more in sports through conversations like these. So I would like to thank you once again for taking out the time to join us here today.
Thank you
so much, Samina ma'am.
Thank you. Pleasure is all mine. Thank you, Anupriti.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Miss Samina Warsi joining us all the way from Lucknow and talking to us about how she and her school is collaborating with national level sports academies like KD Singh Babu Stadium in Lucknow to promote more and more sports, because sports definitely leads to holistic development of children. And like I told you earlier during the start of the show, Team India has bagged a double gold at the International Chess Olympiad. And you saw the visuals right there. You saw how grandly Team India is celebrating its win, which is filled with grandeur. That's how you celebrate a historic win. That's how you create history as well. India has won a double gold at the 45th International Chess Federation, or the FIDE Chess Olympiad in Hungary's Budapest. Viewers, let me tell you, of the 188 teams that participated, India won both the men's and the women's competitions, in addition to winning the team championships. India also walked away with 4 individual gold medals, with D. Gukesh, Arjun Erigesi, Divya Deshmukh and Avantika Agarwal claiming individual honours this particular year. The men's team this year was absolutely formidable. winning all their rounds. Can you believe that? Meanwhile, the women's team managed to cross the line, sealing the gold in the last round. This happened despite the absence of Konaru Hampi. She is India's top-ranked women's player. She chose this time to sit out of the Olympiad, and despite this, the team still won the gold. And for both the teams, this was one of the most dominant performances in the history of chess. This is the first time that India won the men's and the women's draws at the Olympiads. This also happens to be the third time that a country has the double gold at the same tournament. The previous two being China and Soviet Union, who had long been considered the chess powerhouses. But the history scripting, viewers, does not end here. For the first time ever, two Indians are in the top 5 chess live ratings. 18-year-old D. Gukesh and 21-year-old Arjun Erigesi. Gukesh is now aiming to win the world crown in November this year. While success there is not guaranteed, right now people everywhere across the country, people are celebrating India's win in chess. Former women's world champion, the legendary Susan Polgar, says, and I'm quoting her here, "This team," and by this team she means this Indian team, "will stay on top for years to come, and India is now officially the best chess nation in the world," unquote. That's what she has to say about our teams. Others too share her sentiment, like Hungarian grandmaster Peter Leko. He says, quote, "India is way too strong. They're very young, very determined. They're brilliantly prepared. They also have fantastic chemistry. And so, it's a very tough team for anyone to beat," unquote. India's chess superiority is like that of the legendary USSR teams back in the 1950s and 1960s, viewers, when the teams were sprouting one world champion after another, and they rarely lost a game. Gukesh and Erigesi this year could be the Karpov and Kasparov of the 2020s, for all you know, viewers. After all, India is now a chess superpower, all thanks to the golden generation that's showcasing India's prowess. And this has been the greatest chess year for the country. Apart from making history at the Olympiad, let me tell you, in April this year, 3 Indians made the cut for the Elite Candidates Tournament for the first time, besides 2 women competing in the women's competition. Among these 5 players, Gukesh became the youngest ever to win the event. In June, apart from this, let me tell you, apart from this, R. Pragna Nandha, he took down world number 1 Magnus Carlsen for the first time in history in the classical format at the Norway Chess Tournament. And now, viewers, Gukesh could cap it off by becoming the youngest world champion in history. The world and India will be watching. But no matter what the outcome, one thing is clear, viewers. One thing is clear for all to see. India's chess reign has just begun. And viewers, this is not the first time that India has made history in the world of chess. This pattern of writing history in chess started way back in 2020. An important milestone for chess was achieved that year, 4 years ago. R. Pragna Nandha, who won the Arjuna Award, the second highest sporting honor in India, for his phenomenal performances in the last few years, as he was called on the stage to receive the award from President Draupadi Murmu. The narrator spoke about his achievements. Listen to this. Gold medal at the FIDE Online Olympiad 2020. And then bronze medal at the FIDE Online Olympiad next year, 2021. Followed by bronze medal at the FIDE Chess Olympiad 2022. That's 3 feats right there. Prague recently also won the Asian Championships and has the unique distinction of beating the world champion Magnus Carlsen 5 times in the year 2022. Viewers, you should know, the Arjuna Award is the second highest sporting honor in our country. The recipients of the Arjuna Award are selected by a committee that is constituted by the ministry and are honored for their good performance in the field of sports over a period of 4 years at the international level and for having shown qualities of leadership, sportsmanship, and a strong sense of discipline. Take a look at this special report.
शतरंज के उत्कृष्ट खिलाड़ी श्री आर प्रज्ञानंदा ने 44वें शतरंज ओलंपियाड 2022 में कांस्य पदक टीम, FIDE ऑनलाइन ओलंपियाड 2021 में कांस्य पदक टीम, FIDE ऑनलाइन ओलंपियाड 2020 में स्वर्ण पदक टीम जीते। श्री आर प्रज्ञानंदा को शतरंज में उनकी उपलब्धियों को मान्यता देते हुए वर्ष 2022 के लिए अर्जुन पुरस्कार से सम्मानित किया जाता है। श्री आर प्रज्ञानंदा, शतरंज की उत्कृष्ट खिलाड़ी सुश्री आर वैशाली ने 2023 को हांगशू में आयोजित 19वें एशियाई खेल में रजत पदक महिला टीम, 2021 FIDE ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में कांस्य पदक टीम, 2020 FIDE ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में स्वर्ण पदक टीम जीता। सुश्री आर वैशाली को उनकी उपलब्धियों को मान्यता प्रदान करते हुए वर्ष 2023 के लिए अर्जुन पुरस्कार दिया जाता है। सुश्री आर वैशाली, श्री आर बी रमेश, शतरंज की उत्कृष्ट खिलाड़ी सुश्री आर वैशाली ने 2023 को हांगशू में आयोजित 19वें एशियाई खेल में रजत पदक महिला टीम, 2021 FIDE ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में कांस्य पदक टीम, 2020 FIDE ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में स्वर्ण पदक टीम जीता। सुश्री आर वैशाली को उनकी उपलब्धियों को मान्यता प्रदान करते हुए वर्ष 2023 के लिए अर्जुन पुरस्कार दिया जाता।
Yeah, it's amazing. Like, I mean, I've witnessed something like this when, like, 10 years back when Vishyanand sir had won World Championship match. Like, we had fantastic welcome. We went to airport actually to receive. We were one of them, and it's amazing to see that Prague is getting the same love and from all the people, from the school management, the government, and I mean, all the people around here. I mean, it's just fantastic. Silver is itself, and it's a fantastic thing. It's, I mean, after 20 years, like.
I'm here with Nagalakshmi and Pragnananda. Hello, hi.
Yes,
congratulations for such a great performance of Prague in the World Cup.
Thank you.
How was it for you? So, you are satisfied?
Yeah, she's happy.
Okay. What was your main role there? You have said is to also like take care of him and also to cook food. Yes. So what is the one food that you cooked a lot there?
Sambar. Main sambar.
Vegetable
sambar. Only reason protein.
So protein gives lot of energy. For 1 month it is important. You will put lot of vegetables in it.
Yeah, or necessary stuff.
Okay. Then lot of photos were taken of you.
I'm here with Mr. Ramesh Babu, father of Pragnananda and Vaishali.
Good morning, Sagar.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm very good. How are you doing?
Fine.
So the main aim of this interview is to know more about you and also how Prag and Vaishali have become such strong players. So could you tell us a bit about when were you born and where?
I was born during 1966 in Chengalpattu district. Now I am residing in Chennai. I am working in TNSC Bank as Assistant General Manager. My wife name is Nagalakshmi. I have two children, you know very well, Vaishali and Pragnananda. Then?
Yeah. So, I wanted to know that you yourself have gone through a tough phase.
Yes.
In your life. Yes. You have been struck with polio. So, when did that happen and how it happened?
Yeah, right from the beginning. When I was a child, I was severely attacked by fever. From that day itself, I have a problem.
Right.
Received the prestigious Arjuna Award from the Honorable President Draupadi Murmu the next year, the very next year in 2023, viewers. Her brother bagged the Arjuna Award in 2022, and the very next year, his sister bags the same Arjuna Award in 2023. Two grandmasters within the same family. What a wonderful achievement for India. Brother-sister duo. Both of them are grandmasters in chess. One can only imagine how proud their parents must be. And the super coach of India, who has helped a huge number of Indian chess players to become grandmasters, including the world-renowned Vishwanathan Anand. The coach of Pragnananda and R. Vaishali, grandmaster himself, Ramesh RB, he received the Dronacharya Award the same year. Take a look at this.
Shri R.B. Ramesh. शतरंज की उत्कृष्ट खिलाड़ी सुश्री आर वैशाली ने 2023 को हांगशू में आयोजित 19वीं एशियाई खेल में रजत पदक महिला टीम 2021 एफआईडीई ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में कांस्य पदक टीम 2020 एफआईडीई ऑनलाइन शतरंज ओलंपियाड में स्वर्ण पदक टीम जीता। सुश्री आर वैशाली को उनकी उपलब्धियों को मान्यता प्रदान करते हुए वर्ष 2023 के लिए अर्जुन पुरस्कार दिया जाता है। सुश्री आर वैशाली।
Indians have been bagging medals in the field of sports for a long time now. But when it comes to chess, something changes, something shifts, something is different. Have you noticed that chess demands sharpness of the mind? And Indians have proven time and again that they are extremely sharp. Look at Sunita Williams. The famous NASA astronaut, she's an Indian as well. She's at NASA. Indians are sharp. And because of that sharpness of mind, this year too, they have bagged a double gold along with four individual golds. They are all golds. And that too in the sport of chess. And not just for this year. Like this special report tells you, this journey has been going on for quite a long time. India has been writing history, literally history, in the sport of chess for a long time. With such grandmasters being manufactured, not produced, manufactured by the country year after year with roaring success. It is something about the sharp Indian mind that comes through our Sanskriti, through our culture, through our upbringing, Indians are sharp. And these recent gold wins in chess at FIDE go ahead to prove just that. I believe it's high time that sports like chess are promoted more and more in our country, across the social fabric of our country, and more parents become aware that their children could have a bright future in any sport that requires mental toughness and sharpness. And with that, viewers, we come to the end of this special episode of